What's going on, guys? Night Rainbow here with another reaction video. And I'm going to be taking a look at the first part of a five-part series called Phoenix Wright Turnabout Storm. This was requested me a while back, months ago, around the same time as I was requesting my little portal. But, the only thing I know about Phoenix Wright is that it's a video game. I've never played it. I've only just recently heard about it when this got requested to me. So, I guess it's a sort of, like, court system case thing. I have no clue. That's what it looked like. I know they're currently making a sequel series to this. I remember seeing the trailer for that. So, I'm going to get through this and see what goes on. After this first part, I noticed that the other four or five, I think four parts, were at least an hour long. So what I might do is, if you guys want, I'll split each of those parts into shorter parts, maybe like 30 minutes each. Or if you'd rather, I can upload the full length of it. It'll take longer for me to render out, but it's less editing for me, so I'm good with either way. If I don't get any feedback on that, I'll probably just split into multiple parts. But with that said, let me get this started and see what happens. Start in 3, 2, 1, start. Something just happened. Oh, are they actually doing this in like the style of the video game? That's kind of cool.
Wright & Co. office, defending you like it's nothing, baby.
Oh my god.
No, sorry. I don't need a vegetable dicer. I'm sure that... that silly slogan Maya came up with must be what's making business a slow. I should really have it revised.
Yeah, probably.
I need to have it revised.
Yeah, there you go.
What a ridiculous slogan. Who are we trying to attract? Grade school students? I guess it is a good sign, though. The less people are in need of an attorney, the less problems there are in the world. Unfortunately, sunshine and smiles don't pay the bills. Guess I can at least call it in early tonight.
What's going
on? Fuck?
I can't move my body! Wait. Is my hand fading away? Getting dizzy. Am I dying?
Hey, who the heck are you?
Whose voice is that?
For that matter, what the heck are you?
What am I? What kind of question is that? Does she mean my profession?
I wanted the best defense attorney in Equestria, not some porcupine thing.
Oh, God.
Does my hair really look like a porcupine? My muscles are coming, too. I think I can open my eyes.
Huh? Oh, in Twilight's library?
Hey, yeah. You're Hello. A human, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm a human.
Wait, what?
A human in Equestria. That's amazing!
You're a talking horse!
Excuse me. I am not a horse. I happen to be a pony.
That face is so cute.
A talking pony! That explains everything! I must be in a dream. A really, really bad dream.
I'm pretty sure you're not, but let's conduct an experiment.
Ow! What was that for?
You acknowledged pain. therefore that definitely means you aren't dreaming.
This thing has a really strong sense of humor.
Yeah, she looked really crazy there. Attorney?
Of course I am! Why am I talking to it?
Oh, oops. My mistake.
What do you mean, oops?
I performed a spell to summon the greatest defense attorney in Equestria.
What's Equestria?
The name of this country.
But I'm not from this country!
I must have left out the Equestria part when I cast the spell.
Twilight, come on.
I called upon the greatest defense attorney, period. Go figure, huh?
Oh, Cosmos, you flatter me.
Huh!
Can you please send me back? Like, right now?
Sure thing. Actually, this is perfect.
Oh, please don't tell me this is going where I think it is.
Oh, it is.
I'm in need of a really good defense attorney.
And it does go where I think it is.
And you just happen to be here.
Actually, you kidnapped me with your freaky spell, remember?
Minor setback.
Minor?!
Yes, but would you be willing to represent my friend?
Honestly, I'm still shocked I'm in a library talking to a purple horse. I mean, pony. Can you just send me back home, please? And get someone else to do it?
Look, I really need help. My friend's life is at stake here.
Let me just get my head together. This is a little too much for me. First off, who are you and where am I?
My name is Twilight Sparkle. I'm a disciple of Princess Celestia, the monarch of this land. I'm chronicling the magic of friendship for her, and you're in the town of Ponyville.
Celestia? Magic of friendship? Ponyville? Wait a minute. Are you saying there's more talking ponies?
Mm-hmm. Almost all of Ponyville's inhabitants are ponies.
Oh, joy.
Hence the name Ponyville.
Better and better.
Hey, I know. Be right back.
Whoa. Is she moving books around with that horn?
Found it. Here you go. You're new here, so you can meet this, detailed encyclopedia of the different ponies in Equestria.
Hmm. Wait, this says it's for early ages on the cover. This is a children's book!
Well, you see, this stuff is kind of common knowledge around here.
You call this detailed? I read the whole book cover to back in 10 seconds flat. Hey, I'm sorry. I guess I shouldn't look a gift horse in the mouth.
Oh my god, really?
Can I have a pony there, I wonder?
No, it's not that. It's my friend. I know she's not guilty, but she's going to be punished for a crime she didn't commit.
What kind of crime is she being accused of?
Murder.
Surprise, surprise.
Murder never happens in Ponyville, or Equestria for that matter. So the punishment is very severe.
What is the punishment?
Banishment.
Well, that isn't so bad compared to...
To the moon, or even the sun. I've convinced the princess to go easy on her, but she will have no choice if the verdict ends up being guilty.
And forget what I just said. Sheesh. Being sent to the sun is going easy on someone? Remind me never to do anything bad in this place.
Yeah, seriously.
So, Twilight, do you know any details about the crime?
Not much. All I know was my friend was near the scene of the crime when the murder took place. And that is why she's the prime suspect.
Where is she right now?
In the Ponyville Detention Center.
Have you spoken with her since?
I would, but the guards won't let me in.
They won't let you in? Why not?
I can only get in there with a defense attorney, which is why I was trying to call one.
Okay, then. Since I'm a defense attorney, let's go to this detention center.
Really? So you'll take the case?
Hey, I haven't decided that yet. I just thought the least I could do is help you get in and speak with your friend.
Thank you for your kindness, Phoenix Wright.
How did you know my name? I haven't introduced myself yet.
Oh, I did a quick identification spell.
Identification spell?
Yeah, an identification spell. Anyway, let me prepare a few things, then we can go to the detention center.
You summoned them on purpose, didn't you?
After I get her inside with a friend, I'll let her off easy and make her send me back home. There's no way I'm taking a case this weird. Never felt like such a minority in my life.
Oh, it wasn't that bad.
All those ponies were gawking at me the whole way here.
Mr. Wright, humans have almost never been seen in all of Equestria. In fact, you may be the first one in Ponyville. You should be honored.
Honored? Strolling around a town infested with candy-colored equines? Yeah, maybe I'd feel honored if I was, oh, I don't know, a 5-year-old girl. So, how did you know I was a human?
I read a lot. I've read almost every book in my library 5 times over, and I'm familiar with a lot of different species. Chimeras, trolls, basilisks, goblins, etc., etc.
She's read every book in that gigantic library 5 times?
Anyway, we're here, Phoenix.
Yeah, you'll figure that out real quick.
Only a lawyer can enter the detention center.
Well, go on.
Hi, guys. I'm a lawyer.
Identification.
Ah, right here. Never leave home without it.
What is that?
Is that a toy? You look a little old to be playing with toys.
Next time I'm leaving it at home.
You cannot pass without valid equestrian identification.
But I don't have any.
Then beat it, Spikey.
Twilight, they're not letting me in.
Oh, that's right. Mr. Wright, I was supposed to give you this. The princess ordered me to give you this earlier today. A permit to defend in Equestria.
I see. Wait, I thought you accidentally brought me here. How could your princess have had that prepared for me?
Because it wasn't an accident.
What I meant was I had my assistant Spike prepare it before we left.
Spike? I didn't see anyone else in that library.
He was sleeping. It's late, as you can see. I had to wake him up and have him prepare it. That's why it took a little while to leave. I'll properly introduce you to him later.
You prepared a permit in 20 minutes? I find that a little fishy.
Save the questions for my friend. Just take the badge.
This isn't helping me accept your request, you know. Heart. My masculinity. Going. Going. Gone.
Come on, hurry up. Visiting
now, that only happens if you watch the movie Twilight.
All right, no need to shove me. Okay, guys. Here it is. This is so degrading.
Permission granted. You may enter.
Whew. Alrighty. Come on, Twilight. You can go speak with your friend now.
Sorry, Phoenix.
Sorry? About what?
I'm not allowed in. Only attorneys are allowed to speak with suspects.
But you said...
I know I said I'd talk to her, but... It'd be better if you got all the details about the crime to make your judgment. Please, just hear her out. If you don't want to do it after that, I'll send you back where you came from.
But I... Should I really be doing this? Should I really be meddling in some other world's affair?
Do it.
Maybe I should at least hear what all this fuss is about. Fine.
Thank you so much, Mr. Wright.
The Ponyville actually has a detention center.
Twilight's friend.
Hey!
Of course, Rainbow Dash.
What did I do?
I don't think they allow animals in here. You should get out before they toss you in here, too.
Look, I'm not an animal. I'm a human being.
Oh, I didn't mean you. I meant that thing on your head.
Oh, my God.
If someone makes fun of my hair one more time.
So I'm guessing you're my lawyer, huh?
Yes, Twilight Sparkleson. Wait, no! I haven't agreed to anything yet!
Jeez, Twilight knows how to pick 'em. What are you doing here, then?
I just want information regarding the crime you're being accused of. Let's start off with your name.
I'm Rainbow Dash, best flyer in Ponyville, soon to be a household name in whole of Equestria. Line up for my autograph starts over there!
Oh my God.
Twilight Sparkle, Rainbow Dash... Is it me or their names starting to sound like flavors of ice cream? I'm Phoenix Wright.
Probably is.
Best attorney in the universe, apparently.
Phoenix? Sweet name. But it could sound cooler.
Oh, jeez.
Cooler?
I think I'll call you Nyx. That sounds cool.
Another strange name I can add to my nickname checklist. So you're an Earth Pony, correct?
Nope.
What the hey are you talking about? I'm not an Earth Pony, I'm a Pegasus!
Never mind that. Why are you in here anyway? It's kind of sad I couldn't get down a book with 12 words.
Well, I guess I can tell you all I know. Last night, a Pegasus named Acewhip was killed in the Everfree Forest.
Do you know anything about him?
Sure do! He was a hotshot racer expected to win the Equestrian 500.
Equestrian 500?
A grueling race for Pegasi. And during a 500-mile journey around Equestria, he was the top pick to win the whole thing. Don't worry, though.
Don't worry? About what?
I still would have won even if you were still alive! Ha!
Let me guess, you were planning on entering that race as well.
Of course! The winner gets special lessons from the Wonderbolts!
And that was the motive.
You don't know who the Wonderbolts are? Are you living under a rock or something?
No, he's a human.
Hey, I'm new here. Cut me some slack.
The Wonderbolts are only the most coolest ponies in all of Equestria. They are the princess's personal aerial acrobatic team. The stunts they pull are 9 degrees of cool. See, I've been trying to get in their team forever. And the Equestrian 500 is my ticket to show off my slick moves to them. I'd do anything to get that chance.
Thank you for effectively establishing a motive for yourself.
Yeah, exactly.
This helps your case so much. So how did this guy die?
Pony.
What?
How did this pony die is what you mean, Nix.
Well, excuse me. I didn't take Hooked on Ponies.
Yeah.
The point is, how did he die?
How should I know? I didn't do it.
Then why did they take you in?
I just happened to be flying near the Everfree Forest that night. Then those chuckleheads burst in my house and brought me in here saying I did it. They even said they had lots of proof, but I would never do that to another pony.
They just took you in like that?
They said they're going to banish me.
So I heard.
Everyone thinks I did it. Everyone. The Wonderbolts probably hate me. But you believe me, right?
Well, I guess. But not everyone thinks you did it.
Huh?
Your friend Twilight seems to have faith in you. Otherwise, I wouldn't be in this mess.
You're right, I guess. Twilight's a real pal. What do you mean by mess, anyway?
You see, as you can probably already guess, I'm not from Equestria. Your purple friend pulled me out of my world because she accidentally called the greatest defense attorney. And that just so happened to be me.
Awesome! It's only fitting. The best Pegasus ever gets the best lawyer ever! You were destined to defend me!
Rainbow.
This one's ego is larger than Detective Gumshoe's appetite for instant.
Nix, as much as I hate asking for help, can you please be my attorney?
I feel kind of sorry for her. She sounds like she's telling the truth, and I want to say yes, but should I? Well, oh, wait a minute! I believe her, but I better make sure.
Huh. Okay.
Is that a toy? You look a little too old to be playing with toys, Nix.
Look, Rainbow Dash, I'm gonna ask you this, and I want you to tell me the absolute 100% truth. Did you have anything to do with the death of Ace Swift?
I told you, I didn't kill any pony!
Damn.
Huh?
Nothing. It's certain that she really didn't do it.
Okay, Rainbow Dash.
What? Why did you go all silent there?
I've decided to take your case. I trust you.
Yes! Alright! I knew you can do it, Nix!
I suppose the first thing I should do is investigate the scene of the crime for some evidence to prove your innocence. Where was it again?
A clearing in the Everfree Forest.
Everfree Forest?
Yeah, it's about 15 minutes from Fluttershy's house.
Fluttershy, huh?
Yeah,
probably another pony.
Well, good luck.
You gotta be a little more clear with
directions
here, Rainbow.
I look a little strange? Coming from the Roy G. Biff pony with wings, you look strange even by Ponyville standards.
I mean, yeah.
Right. There's one more question I wanted to ask you.
Shoot.
What were you doing near the crime scene anyway?
Uh-oh.
Well?
I was practicing for the Equestrian 500. Yup.
Oh,
what
the hell?
Doing, practicing for the big race.
Cyclops. You're a bad liar. Even without this thing, I can tell you're hiding something from me.
Look, Rainbow Dash, if I'm going to defend you, you're going to need to be honest with me.
I told you a dozen times already. I didn't do it.
I'm not saying you did it. I'm just wondering what you were doing near the scene of the crime.
Well... Uh-oh. Looks like visiting hours are over.
Huh.
Catch you later, Nix.
Hey, no they aren't. There's still 5 minutes left.
She's gone. Oh well.
I probably need more information to pursue that any further anyway. As long as she didn't do it, that's all I need to know for now.
Phoenix, how did it go?
I've decided to represent Rainbow Dash.
Oh, thank you so much, Mr. Wright!
She said she didn't do it, and I can't turn my back on the innocent being punished for something they didn't do.
You share a very similar trait to Rainbow Dash, Mr. Wright.
I do? Am I really that obnoxious?
No, you are very loyal. She probably may not have looked it, but Rainbow Dash is probably really scared about what is going to happen to her. So she needs all the support she can get right now.
Now that you mention it, she did seem awfully chipper for someone being a prime suspect in murder.
I can't imagine what it must be like.
I've been in that place before.
That place? What do you mean by that, Phoenix?
I've been on trial for crimes I didn't commit. I know how she probably feels.
You have?
It felt dark and lonely having nobody to turn to. Feeling as if the world was against me and nobody could help. Once when I was just a kid, my whole class accused me of stealing and we had this stupid class trial. The other time was a little more serious. I was framed for murder by someone who thought cared for me. I learned the hard way appearances can be deceiving. But I was lucky to have friends who pulled me out of that darkness. It really touched me. It's what made me decide to become a defense attorney. A defense attorney is someone who's there for you when times are grim, showing you you have someone who trusts and believes in you, that you're not alone, smiling to the very end, no matter how bad things may get.
I'm gonna guess that's from one of the games.
Right. You know, I was going to study some law and justice books and be Rainbow Dash's defense attorney myself if you declined. But I see now that there's some knowledge out there even books can't teach. It was no mistake choosing you to be Rainbow Dash's lawyer.
Chose? Didn't you bring me here by accident?
She keeps slipping up.
Did you get anything else from Rainbow Dash?
Yes. She said the crime scene was in the clearing of the Everfree Forest, near Butcherstye's house.
Butcherstye? Oh, you mean Fluttershy!
Do you know the way?
Sure do.
Let's go then.
Phoenix, we should stop here.
Why's that? Oh, this must be Flutterscotch's house.
Scott!
We'll probably question her and see if she saw anything last night.
Her name is Fluttershy. And those were my thoughts exactly.
Oh my god.
Hey, Fluttershy.
She's so freaked out.
He's Rainbow Dash's lawyer.
Hello there. Nice to meet you. So, Ponyville's a really nice place, huh? Talk about quiet. Certainly lives up to her name.
Okay.
What's she saying?
She's saying suits and ties intimidate her.
Trust me, they scare me too.
Never mind.
Tell me, she can rest assured she has nothing to fear.
Well, she says she's afraid if she gets too close, that pointy beast on your head might pull.
Seriously, the hair jokes are getting old. So she isn't gonna speak to me?
Sorry, she's kind of shy.
No kidding. Let's go to the crime scene then. We're not gonna get any info here if she's refusing to speak with me.
The crime scene is right over here, Phoenix.
Okay. Huh?
Phoenix?
Yeah, that's my name.
Oh my, I am so sorry. I didn't know.
Well, that changed real quick. Oh my god, Fluttershy!
Come again.
No wonder you look so homely and sick. Don't worry though, soon you will be able to rise from your ashes into a beautiful bird of fire.
Oh my god.
Did I just get insulted? But I'm not a-
Phoenix!
What?
She's speaking to you, just go along with it.
Oh, that's right. Yep, I'm a Phoenix Firefly.
My name is Fluttershy, Mr. Phoenix, but you can call me whatever you want.
I take it you know about your friend Rainbow Dash.
Yes, I do. Poor Rainbow Dash, she was
you see anything suspicious last night?
Why, yes, I did.
That's great! Tell me everything you know.
Well, I saw... Oops. Oh, I'm so sorry, Mr. Phoenix.
What?
The other ponies told me not to say a word to anyone about last night until I was on the stand. Whatever that means.
Wait a minute! You're a witness?
I don't even know what that is, Mr. Phoenix.
You sure your name's not Flutter Naive?
Hey.
It's okay. It'll be our little secret. Just tell me what you saw.
Come on, Fluttershy. We need to know.
I'm sorry, Twilight, but I don't want those ponies to be mad at me.
Why can this never be easy? So what is it that you do, Fluttershy?
I take care of my little animal friends, of course.
So you're good with animals, huh? I don't find that surprising, since she is, well, an animal herself.
Yes, I can introduce you to them if you want.
That's all right. We're kind of busy.
Oh my, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to bother you.
It's all right. No need to apologize.
We have to get going, Fluttershy. We'll talk to you later.
All right. Bye, Twilight. Bye, Mr. Phoenix.
At least I got her trust. It'll be a little easier inevitably cross-examining her when we're in court. Speaking of that, when is the trial anyway?
Tomorrow morning. Yep.
Oh, tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning? As in tomorrow?
Yep, tomorrow.
So I only have a few hours to gather evidence and present a case?
Phoenix, what have you gotten yourself into?
Oh my gosh, I totally lost track of time. I've been trying to get a suitable lawyer all day long. I was just going to give up after you.
Give up after me? You mean I'm not the only lawyer you've spoken with today?
That is correct. They all declined, though, as soon as murder was brought up.
Don't worry. Murder cases aren't anything new to me. I have a lot of experience with them. Rainbow Dash couldn't be in any better hands.
Thank you again for accepting this, Phoenix. But we better hurry to the crime scene, though.
Right.
Welcome to the Everfree Forest, Mr. Wright.
Kinda spooky.
There are many deadly creatures in the Everfree Forest. Every pony tends to avoid entering here because of that.
Deadly creatures?
Yeah.
Ah! Something just touched my hand!
That was just my tail. Don't worry, Phoenix. We aren't that deep. Most of the menacing things live further in.
Okay.
Come on. Don't be such a chicken, Phoenix.
Yeah, stop being a Scootaloo.
There's a clearing. This must be it.
Hard to believe some pony died here.
Aren't there any crime scene investigators?
They're probably all finished up.
Bonus for me, I guess. Let's get down to work then. But there's one little problem. It's way too dark here.
I was gonna say.
I can't see anything. I don't have a flashlight.
Let me take care of that.
It's that horn again. It's lighting up like a candle. That must be really handy. Good work, Twilight.
All right, let's find some clues.
She seems really eager to start this off. Hey, look at this.
Why is there tape all over the grass?
If it's anything like my world, this is probably where they found Ace Swift's body.
Ugh, I think I'm going to be sick.
And all that eagerness seemed to go away in one fell swoop.
Wait, the victim was Ace Swift?
That's what Rainbow Dash told me.
Ace Swift. Oh.
It's strange, though. There's no blood at all. Ponies can bleed, right?
Of course they can.
It's just really strange there's a murder, but not a drop of blood in sight.
This grass is odd, too. It's all black.
You're right. It's all charred and burnt like there was a small fire around the body.
Steel Samurai? That sure is an interesting-looking camera, Phoenix.
It's not mine. It belongs to a friend. Hey, maybe I should tell Twilight about the Steel Samurai. Amazing how a kid's show got so popular outside of the targeted demographic.
Hey, look there. That thing on the ground next to where the body was.
It's a... What the heck is this thing?
I don't have any idea.
Whatever it was, it's totally burnt to a crisp.
Just like the grass.
This may be important evidence.
Metal object.
Let's look at that dirt landscape over there.
I have no idea what that thing looks like.
What's this?
There's an imprint of something in the dirt. Something long.
That isn't what I find odd.
What do you mean?
Look next to it. Someone obviously disturbed the dirt here.
Now that you mention it, this doesn't look natural at all. It looks like some pony was kicking the dirt around in this area.
See anything else that looks suspicious?
Look at that tree, way over there at the other end of the crime scene.
It's knocked down.
But look at the trunk. It suffers from the same burning as the grass and that object.
Can ponies breathe fire or something?
No, Phoenix. Dragons do that, not ponies.
Maybe a dragon really did do all this.
That isn't possible. Spike is the only dragon in Ponyville, and he was with me all night.
Spike? That's your assistant you told me about. Wait, he's a dragon? There really are dragons here?
Like, yes.
You said you wanted to introduce me to him. It's quite alright. You don't need to. He's probably a really nice guy.
Don't be so shy. Spike loves company.
I really hope there isn't a double meaning to that.
Oh, Phoenix, look on that branch there, on that tree behind the fallen one.
There's something stuck on it. I'll climb up and get it.
No need, Mr. Wright.
Or you could just float it down.
Brown feather. Well, that was pointless. Probably from a bird.
No, it can't be. No bird in Ponyville is this big.
I know. Maybe it's the victim's. He was a Pegasus, right? Maybe it's from his wings.
Nope, this feather doesn't belong to a pony either. Too big.
Griffin?
Then we should keep it.
But the only other...
How do you do that, Twilight?
The only other thing I can think of is a griffin.
Say what, Phoenix?
I've seen you levitating things with that horn of yours. Not to mention you're lighting this whole area with it this very moment.
It's magic. Levitation and illumination. Two of the basic spells a unicorn can learn. Why do you ask? Is there no magic in your world?
No, there isn't. But actually, you could say there is.
Please do tell. You see, magic is sort of my bread and butter. I want to learn everything there is to know about it.
Well, I've been able to speak to the dead via spirit channeling. That could be considered magic, I guess.
Spirit channeling?
It's when the spirit of someone who's departed possesses the body of the living. I've used it to keep in touch with someone very dear to me.
Oh, I get it. Hey, Phoenix, can't you do it right now? We can get Ace Swift in your body and ask who killed him.
Sorry, I forgot to mention. You have to be a high-level spirit medium in order to perform the channeling technique. My friend is the one who normally does it.
Right.
I see. Thanks for the information, though. I'll definitely look into it more.
No decisive evidence yet. We still don't even know how this guy died. Hey, Twilight, do you know anything about him?
I know a bit of information about him.
Alright, anything helps.
Well, Ace was an athlete who got extremely popular around Equestria by winning every event he's ever competed in.
He won every single event he's competed in?
Yeah, he was that good. But with this streak of success, he gained a few skeptics, thinking that all his victories were a result of cheating and other dubious methods.
Of course.
I'd probably think the same if I saw someone winning at everything they do.
He was supposed to be competing in the Equestrian 500, and was the racer expected most likely to win.
Rainbow Dash told me about that too. Unfortunately, it sets up a motive for her.
What do you mean?
Rainbow Dash said she was planning on flying in that race as well, and she seemed really, well, determined on winning it.
Yes, I remember her going around Ponyville, bantering how she was going to be the one to take the gold.
If she were to rub out the guy most likely to win, she would have more of a chance of winning the whole thing herself.
But she wouldn't do that!
Yes, yes, I know. But we're gonna have to prove otherwise to those who probably suspect that in court tomorrow.
Sorry, I guess you're right.
Can't say I'm really satisfied with the evidence we gathered. But this looks like all we're gonna find here for now.
The ponies investigating the crime scene must have taken all the important stuff.
I'm sure we'll see it presented in tomorrow's trial in one form or another. In any case, we should get some rest.
What? No studying or anything?
Don't worry, I do it all the time. If I just keep my eyes set on the truth, everything will be fine.
I hope you really are the best defense attorney, Mr. Wright.
We have a big day ahead of us tomorrow.
You can sleep at my house. I have an extra bed for you.
I still feel like I shouldn't be taking this case. I'm an outsider meddling in something that doesn't even concern me at all. But at the same time, I can't turn my back on someone who's being accused for a crime they didn't commit. That just goes against everything I stand for. This whole thing is still really weird. Talking ponies and all. But I said I would defend Rainbow Dash, and that's what I'm going to do. I need to bring my A-game tomorrow. Even with little evidence, I'll find the truth and get Rainbow Dash acquitted of this murder.
Is that Trixie? Oh god. And of course all the music is from that game. Alright. Pretty interesting. Definitely gonna have to check out the rest of these. Getting done before the sequel comes out. So yeah, let me know if you guys want me to split up the rest of the videos into multiple parts, shorter 30 minute longer ones, or if you'd rather just have me upload the full video. I'm cool with either way. But with that said, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Take it easy. Your lies, seeing you hurts my eyes.